In this video, we'll demonstrate how to install watch hands for freehand watches such as the dive watch we have here. You should be able to use the same technique for modding Seikos and many other watches. For other content, such as the removal of watch hands, we have links below in the description. The second hand installation is very challenging for most beginners, and you run the risk of damaging a movement if you do it incorrectly. Therefore, we made a separate video for it. The link is in the description. For hand installation, you'll need a hand installation tool and a pair of tweezers or Rodico to pick up the watch hands. A loupe and a set of hand removal tools are also recommended, as you'll likely need them as well. For the hand installation tool, this type is more than enough for most cases. For hour and minute hand installation, choose the tip that has the center hole slightly larger than the post of a minute wheel. If the hole is too big, you'll have worse control and risk bending the watch hand, while if the hole is too small, you won't be able to set the hour hand. Before we start, I recommend taking a good look at the movement using a loupe if you have one. Be aware of how small and delicate the smallest post is, and be careful not to bend it during the hand installation process. This is where you'll install your sweeping second hand after the hour and minute hands are set. Let's prop up the movement and dial assembly. There are multiple ways to do this, but make sure the bottom side of the movement, the stem and the crown are not taking any pressure during the installation process. In this example, there is only pressure on the movement holder, not on the movement itself, and not on the crown or stem. For most watches, you can use the case back of a watch itself to support the setup like this. In this case, the pad is optional. Just choose a flat surface that won't scratch your case back. You may choose to use one of these movement holders, but be careful when you tighten it not to damage any of the moving components. For some movements, such as the Miyota 8 series, you may have to remove the rotor for a good grip. Okay, let's get started. There are multiple ways to pick up a watch hand. You can pick it up using a pair of tweezers or a Rodico. The top side of the watch hand has a more refined finish. The bottom side is less finished and has a protruding tube. If your movement has a date function, pull the crown all the way out to the time setting position and adjust the time forward until the date time transitions. Once the date ring completes its jump, we install the hour hand, pointing it sharply at 12 o'clock. For all hand installations, we loosely attach them first, so we can check the alignment before setting the hands. Try to keep the tool vertical and align it to the hour wheel. Be careful not to bend the post for the second hand. For no date movements, you can simply install the hour hand and then set it to 12 o'clock. If you have a movement with a date function, let's set the time forward by 24 hours and do a quick check. The date is transitioning when the hour hand is almost pointing at midnight. This is good enough. If your watch hand alignment is off, the best practice is to remove and reinstall it. We have a link for our watch hand removal guide in the description. Keep in mind that the watch hands can become loose if you remove and reinstall them too many times. Let's try to set the hand to its desired height. Use a loupe to take a look at the top of the hour hand and the hour wheel's post. For most standard setups, you should try to press the hour hand down until the top of the hand is flush with the post. For the hour hands only, using the correct hand installation tool, you should be able to push down all the way, as the hour wheel's post will stop the tool at the correct height. Check the assembly with a loupe after each attempt. It is important to get these surfaces to be as nearly as flush as possible. Generally, we try to set all hands as low as possible without touching any components below, as that will leave us more space for components above. Setting your hour hand too high will force you to set the minute and second hands higher, which may result in your second hand getting caught by the crystal. We are also trying to set the hands as level as possible. Adjust the level of the hand gently. A way to do this is to use the hand installation tool. I'm going to exaggerate the motion here to show you how the angle can be adjusted. In practice, you should avoid angling the tool too much and try to just keep the hands as level as possible. A safer method is to use a thin plastic film or even just post-its to gently pull up the tip of a hand upwards. You can use the same technique to adjust the minute and second hand. Now, onto the minute hand. Set the hour hand to 12 o'clock and then install the minute hand pointing at the 60 minute mark. Loosely attach it to check the alignment at 3, 6, 9 and 12 o'clock. Then we can apply pressure to set the minute hand. Unlike the hour hand that we just did, in some cases you won't be able to set the minute hand flush with the post, but it should be pretty close. If you are seeing this, where the minute hand is sitting right on the hour hand and the hour hand has quite a gap between it and the dial, your hour hand is not set low enough. You'll have to remove your minute hand and adjust your hour hand's height. We always check the height and the level of the installation after setting each watch hand. This is how it should look after you set the hour and minute hands to the correct level and height. Okay, now that we have both the hour and the minute hand installed, we can check for alignments and clearance. If the hands are level and low enough, the date ring transitions at midnight, and for each hour, the minute hand is pointing at the 60 minute mark. Then our hour and minute hand installation is complete. For the second hand installation, let's proceed to part 2 of our watch hand installation tutorial. Thanks for watching. Remember to like and subscribe for more watchmaking tutorials and tips.